done again with that American heart, that spirit, that sense of compassion for the worker, the sensitivity toward the employer, and putting together a package that has everyone responded to in a way that speaks to a long overdue bit of success. The last industrialized nation, Representative Garamendi, to go toward a guaranteed health plan. So long overdue, and now to taste success and have it pulled away from the American healthcare consumers of this great nation is a very troubling notion.
Well, Mr. Tonko, thank you very much. Next Monday, did you know, next Monday is the birthday, the annual birthday of Medicare.
Uh-huh.
Next Monday, 1965, it went into effect in 1965, and ever since, as you said earlier, Republicans have been trying to terminate it. They tried again this year, but the American public knows better. They know that they want to live long enough to get to Medicare, because in Medicare, they have a guaranteed benefit. They know that wherever you are in the United States, whether you are in Vermont or in California, you have the same quality policy that'll cover most of what you need. If you want more, you can go out and buy that. That's called the Advantage Program. And you get to choose your doctor. It's not a government takeover at all. In fact, it is a financing mechanism so that every senior in America can choose their own provider. They get to choose their provider. They can go wherever they want to go to get their medical services. And if they don't like the doctor, they can change. So the government is not saying where you can go. In fact, the government is financing the system so you can choose whatever provider you want to choose. That's a common policy across the nation. And it is efficient and it is effective, and the Republicans are trying to destroy it. We won't let that happen. Bottom line, we will not let that happen. And there are serious cost containments in the current Medicare program and in the Affordable Health Care Act. And I'm just going to end with this, and then we really need to get to what we wanted to talk about, which were the job programs. The Congressional Budget Office today estimated that the Affordable Health Care Act over the next 10 years will reduce the deficit by $109 billion. And in the 20 years going out, because of the cost containment in this system, the Affordable Health Care Act will reduce the deficit by over $1 trillion. Now, that's worth engaging. That's worth us doing, and simultaneously provide far better health care to Americans and far better access to health care wherever they may need it across this nation. It's a good thing. And when they want to stand up here and say Obamacare, I'm going, you're right, Obama cares deeply about the very health of every single American. And that's why the Affordable Health Care Act is in place today, was found to be constitutional, does reduce the deficit, and does provide quality health care and choice of where you want to get your medical care.
Mr. My colleague from California just indicated that there would be a deficit, favorable deficit outcome because of Affordable Care Act.
Exactly.
Well, what else reduces the deficit? Putting people to work. Putting people to work, the American Jobs Act, plain and simple.